Hey guys, David Kwan here. So this is the second part of kind of talking about America and gun violence. In the first part, I kind of just talked about the fact that America is number one in gun violence compared to other countries in the developed world. It has the highest rate of gun violence. Now I'm just sticking with gun violence here. That's one of the liberal bias, I think, that is mentioned by a lot of conservatives. It's like, why only guns? You know, why not talk also about crime rate and homicide rates and suicide rates and all that? When you start branching out into those categories, yeah, you're right. The other countries don't have it so awesome. When we're talking about guns, America is number one. But I am omitting the whole discussion about comparing actual crime rates and stuff, which is high, like pretty, you know, relatively similar across the board in all those countries. Considering there's a lot of nuances here and there regarding crime itself. In the first part of, you know, talking about this, I just kind of thought that history had a lot to do with it. American history as a whole, the country was founded basically from a war that started with a gunshot. It's a gunshot that rang across the world. Gun ownership was encouraged, not even encouraged, but mandated a lot of times by local towns. So a person had to own a gun or they were fined. And just this whole historical aspect of it, and also this media culture where the companies that making products are, or news cycles or politicians or whatever, have the public, the viewing public or the reading public or whatever, in constant fear, because that's the best way to sell you something. If you're scared of something, hey, here's a product that can overcome that fear, please buy it. So we have this society of consumerism, which is driven by fear-mongering, and that's one of the main reasons why this gun ownership and gun violence is there. So in this video, I kind of just want to talk about that. Just not only the reason, but if they are the reasons, they're really strong roots. Personally, on a political spectrum in regards to guns, I'm kind of a centrist. So I do tend to favor gun control, but then I have nuances here and there that are more in line with conservative people who want to maintain their gun rights. Thing is, we have the discussion has kind of been from the extremes of both sides for the most part. And what terrifies me the most is if things start happening the way liberals want it to happen, that terrifies me because I've seen the responses from the conservative side in response to that. The reactions are just terrifying. It's been normal to see the reactions being this way, you know, like, oh yeah, they want to confiscate our guns, come for it. You know, there's I don't know how many radio hosts there have been, but there's been a few radio hosts saying like, yeah, come get them. This is our gun, right? We are going to fight. This will be war. There will be blood. That's the reaction. This sentiment of gun ownership and the Second Amendment is so strong in this country I think more Americans feel this way than not. That if we start implementing pretty draconian gun laws in many of those states where gun rights people are more powerful in voice, we're gonna have a civil war on our hands. And that's terrifying to me. The other extreme, of course, this extreme where everyone owns guns, teachers, kids, everyone owns guns because they believe that good guys with guns is the only solution to fight against bad guys with guns. That extreme is also terrifying, because it's just pretty much guns everywhere. That's terrifying. But then this image I have of them implementing pretty like strong gun laws and then the reaction being people fighting back with their guns and the state trying to crack down, that image is an image of civil war, which is even more terrifying to me. It's an interesting thing to think about, like how do we solve this problem? To me, one of the biggest thing that would change this problem is if we're able to, and it kind of seems impossible in thinking about it, but if we were able to somehow lessen the hold of media and commercials and just marketing departments and just subliminal stuff across the board, if we're able to lessen its impact on the culture as a whole in regards to, you know, making people terrified of everything around them, and just kind of this whole, like, I have to fight for my rights. I don't know what's going to come into my house, and I need to protect it with my gun. If we can somehow lessen that paranoia and that tension, that sensation, I think we can, this gun violence problem would be lessened, like, dramatically across the board. I also think gun violence as a whole has a lot to do with many of the, it gets tangled up with a lot of the other issues, I think, especially with poverty, especially with homelessness. As that rises, crime also rises, and because this country has that culture of gun ownership so much, as crime rises, so does gun violence. And also the saddest thing, that's not reported often, but with guns in this country, there's actually more suicide with guns than homicides. So that's a big thing. Up to 20,000 or 30,000 gun-related crimes and tragedies and stuff, more than 60% of that is suicides. So gun ownership makes suicide so more readily possible. So that's another thing to kind of just think about. It is a huge problem. It's one of the biggest problems we have. So what do we do about it? And that's the part where the answer is not easy to come up with. And so in the next video, I will kind of explore that question a bit, thinking about the current state, what's going on around, you know, in this climate currently in America, and also kind of maybe my ideas or my ideals and stuff. So that'll be in the next few videos.